In today's video, I'll share 21 causes of tinnitus. This is one of the most important videos I've ever made because it will empower you to find a treatment plan that's designed for the specific root cause of your tinnitus. This list will cover causes from the ear, the head, the neck, the cardiovascular system, and so much more. So make sure to stick around until the end. Let's start with issues related to the physical ear structures and how they can cause tinnitus. Eustachian tube dysfunction, a very common condition where someone may experience ear pressure, muffled hearing, and tinnitus. It occurs from swelling of the tube that equalizes the pressure between your throat and behind your ears, which can lead to that ringing sound. Meniere's disease, a disorder caused by excessive buildup of fluid deep inside the inner ear, often associated with dizziness and tinnitus. Cholesteatoma, an abnormal growth of skin cells deep inside your ear, sometimes associated with ear infections. It's pretty rare that this will be the cause of your tinnitus, but hang on because we've got some of the most underdiagnosed and common causes of tinnitus coming up in a bit. Hearing loss, the most common cause of tinnitus. According to research, 90% of individuals with tinnitus have some degree of hearing loss. So it may not be the only cause of tinnitus in your case, but it's surely an important factor to consider. Semicircular canal dehiscence. So this part of the inner ear can start to push into a gap in your temporal bone and cause tinnitus. A telltale sign is that people usually get dizzy with elevation changes, but sneezing and coughing can also cause it. A doctor like an ENT physician can insert a patch to stop your semicircular canal from pushing into the temporal bone. Acoustic neuroma. This is a benign tumor on the hearing nerve. My grandfather actually had it and lived many years without needing a surgery or any interventions. Asymmetric hearing loss is a telltale sign, meaning that someone can hear better or worse in just one ear. That also means the tinnitus might exist just on one side or be louder in one ear. And acoustic neuroma is often accompanied by dizziness or a sense of pressure in the ear as well. Earwax. Sometimes Q-tips or consistent use of earplugs can push wax deeper and deeper into the ear until it gets blocked. When sound is prevented from entering your ear canal because of some object blocking the sound, your brain can compensate by making its own noise signal, resulting in tinnitus. Ear infections. This cause of tinnitus often includes things like swimmer's ear or fluid buildup behind the eardrum. Problems with the eustachian tube, as I mentioned earlier, can also leave you prone to have difficulties with ear infections. Now, tinnitus can be caused by ear infections, and it's usually treatable by a doctor, but for serious long-term ear infections, an ENT may insert a small tube in the eardrum or even dilate the eustachian tube to prevent further issues and louder tinnitus. Having a hole in your eardrum. It sounds scary, but the eardrum is actually capable of healing itself. People might get a hole in their eardrum from a Q-tip, fluid buildup that bursts out, or a diving injury. Obviously, a hole is going to affect the ability of your eardrum to transmit sound, and so tinnitus can arise from the lack of sound signal going into your brain. Sometimes the eardrum doesn't heal properly, and an ENT will need to patch it up. For most of the causes we've covered so far, there is a very specific physical cause of the tinnitus. When that cause is treated, the tinnitus can often go away on its own, but it's also possible for the brain to keep generating a tinnitus signal after the initial cause is gone. If that's happening to you, definitely consult with an audiologist. I see this a lot with comments on my earwax video where folks say, hey, the earwax got removed and it's been a few weeks, but I still have tinnitus. Don't worry, there's things we can do to help. Next up, we have a group of tinnitus causes that are called somatic. These are physical issues, usually in your head, neck, or mouth that could be causing your tinnitus. Impacted wisdom teeth or certain infections can actually create pressure in the jaw or the eustachian tube, and that pressure can either pinch your auditory nerve or affect the ability of your eustachian tube to regulate pressure behind your eardrum. TMJ. The temporomandibular joint is an important part of our body, and when this joint has a disorder, it can include arthritis or inflammation, even a dislocated disc. Like troubles with wisdom teeth, the TMJ can put pressure on the auditory nerve and cause tinnitus. Neck issues. Muscle tightness in your neck can pinch your auditory nerve, but weak neck muscles can also create instability and cause tinnitus. A herniated disc in your cervical spine can also cause these nerve-based issues. Physical therapists and orthopedic specialists can usually treat these issues. One of the telltale signs of somatic tinnitus is that your tinnitus can significantly change as you move your head or neck because that nerve is going to get pinched differently as you move that part of your body. Like our previous category, these issues can resolve after treating the root cause, but tinnitus sometimes can persist after the physical issue is treated. In that case, definitely talk to an audiologist for treatment options. Up next, we've got a lot of interesting causes of tinnitus related to migraines, vascular issues, mental health, and in my opinion, the most underdiagnosed but very common cause of tinnitus, so stick around to hear that one. We can lump together cause 13, 14, and 15, which are concussions, skull fractures, and traumatic brain injuries. What happens in these cases is a significant injury to the auditory brain or the middle ear bones leads to tinnitus. Remember that the ear lies within the skull. The ears don't sit in the brain, but they're in the head, so they're inside of the skull. Any damage to the head puts the hearing system at risk of injury, which might lead to tinnitus. In some cases, the brain just needs time to heal, but it's definitely something to talk to a neurologist about if you've had persistent tinnitus and a concussion or a head injury. Migraines. This is a really fascinating one because it's not so well understood how exactly migraines can cause tinnitus. But we do know that migraines can either make your tinnitus worse or it can give you tinnitus if you never had it before. Now, a cause that many people don't talk about is vascular issues. That's anything to do with your blood and its transportation around your body. Problems with the carotid artery. The carotid arteries in your neck can experience plaque buildup, which can cause tinnitus that's usually defined by a pulsing sound. People often report hearing their own heartbeat, which we call pulsatile tinnitus. High blood pressure. Conversely, hypertension can create too much pressure in those tiny veins and similarly create a pulsatile tinnitus sound. Malformations in the blood vessels and arteries. Sometimes the arteries and blood vessels in and around the ear can experience problems that cause tinnitus for similar reasons. Those problems include a tangle of blood vessels that disrupt blood flow, aneurysms, or even vascular loops that compress the auditory nerve in the brain. Like the other causes of tinnitus that have a vascular nature, this one is usually defined by a pulsatile tinnitus sound, and that would lead us towards the correct diagnosis. Finally, we have different causes of tinnitus originating from the emotional regulation of the brain. For number 20, we can lump together depression and anxiety. Your auditory system and limbic system are closely connected in the brain. The limbic system involves a lot of parts essential to your survival, like the fight or flight response, and it gets caught up in how your brain filters certain sounds. You can think of it like a gatekeeper that can mark certain sounds as dangerous or noteworthy. And so when we experience anxiety, all the chemicals rush into our brain associated with that fight or flight gatekeeper component. We might hyperfixate on sounds or stimulus in our environment that we think could threaten us or are very important to our safety and our livelihood. Now, sometimes that gatekeeper function can respond by overzealously flagging noises as something to pay attention to. The same goes for depression. Our negative thought cycles can affect our brain chemistry and our ability to tune out certain sounds. So when we put tinnitus inside of that system, it creates this negative loop, what's sometimes referred to as a Gordian knot, which means that there's a negative feedback cycle. You hear tinnitus, you get worried, you try to fixate on it, the gatekeeper notices this is something that's not pleasant, not welcome, the fight or flight response gets activated, but you can't escape this sound because it's inside of your head, and then the brain latches onto the sound and makes it louder, and that's why the tinnitus, anxiety, stress loop is so tricky, and we must get out of it. Finally, in my opinion, the most underdiagnosed cause of tinnitus is stress. I've had countless patients who've come to me to find out that the root cause of their tinnitus is stress. And when we put a treatment plan together, they're able to experience significant changes and improvements. After I review the patient's test results and get their full case history, I ask one important question. Was there a significant amount of disorder or stress in your life in the 3 to 6 months leading up to the onset of your tinnitus? I wait and I see the patient come to a realization. They often say, yes, there was. No one's ever asked me that. I didn't know that stress could be related to tinnitus. Most commonly, my patients report challenges with family dynamics, relationships, illness, moving, or losing a job. Any of those can create stress on the nervous system, and tinnitus can be a result of that function. Fortunately, we have access to today's leading tinnitus treatments that do a great job at reducing stress-induced tinnitus. Whatever the cause, there are treatments available. Talk to a specialist that can help you find your root cause. My team at Treble Health is here to help. If you'd like to schedule a complimentary consultation, find the link below or call the number on the screen. We're here to help. Have hope. Tinnitus relief is right around the corner, and I'm here to remind you that you can do this.